Jaggi, your computer teacher. Today we are going to discuss about functions in Excel. As we have discussed in our previous class, how to open Excel, how to create or enter data in the cell, and how to select the range of cell, how to rename a worksheet, how to delete a worksheet, and how to insert a new more worksheet in the workbook, and few formulas of Excel we have discussed in the previous class. Today we are going to discuss types of referencing. What is type of referencing? The formulas used in Excel are dynamic in nature. Which formula we are using in Excel are dynamic in nature. This means that the values of the result is recalculated automatically. When we put a formula in any cell, automatically your value get calculated of that cells. If the value of any source cell is are modified, automatically your formula applied on that cell and it will show the changeable value of that cell. This is achieved by using cell referencing in formulas instead of actual value. A reference identifies a cell or a range of cells in the worksheet. As we select, I'm taking this cell, this is the B3 cell, and if I'm selecting whole cell, range of cell in a worksheet, and tell the Excel where to look for the values or the data used in the formula. Here formula is applied on the amount. You can see here in the formula bar, as we have discussed the components here also, this is the formula bar and this is the name box of the Excel. Cell referencing in formulas is in Excel is of three types. Name of them are relative referencing, absolute referencing, and mixed referencing. There are basically three types of referencing: relative referencing, absolute referencing, and mixed referencing. First, we are going to discuss about relative reference. Relative referencing is the default cell referencing used in Excel. This is the default referencing we are using in Excel. As we are saying, address of this cell is B3. That is the cell reference we are using, the B3. That is relative referencing. In the relative referencing, the cell reference of the cell containing the data change when the formula is copied from one cell to the another. Here you can see, here we can take the formula. Here you can see in the formula bar, F4 multiply G4 is equal F4 multiply G4. We are taking here relative referencing. We are taking the name of the cell directly, F4 multiply G4. This is called relative referencing. If I change the cell value, instead of that, if I'll put the column quantity instead of here to somewhere else, it will take the reference of that cell by applying the formula in the specified cell. This is especially useful when some formula is to be entered in many cells. The reference of the cell containing data values need to be changed. Here I have a prior formula in the amount. Formula is equal F4, this is the cell reference, relative reference, F4 multiply G4. F4 and G4 are the relative reference code. We have applied the formula in H4, that is equal F4 multiply G4. Automatically it will take the reference of other cell and find the value in other cell by using the relative reference, by taking the reference of other cells. Just you have to, again I will tell you how I have calculated the formula. Just you have applied the formula in one cell, select that cell, hold the control key. When a plus sign will convert it into the dark plus sign, just drag the mouse cursor till where you want to apply the formula. Automatically value can be calculated in other cell. Value can be calculated in other cells. Again I will tell you, This is called relative reference. This is the by default cell reference in Excel. Another type of referencing we are going to discuss, that is absolute referencing. Absolute reference is a cell reference in a worksheet that remains constant if the formula is copied or moved from one cell to the another cell. Formula remain constant if we copy or move from one cell to another. In case of absolute, there is no change in the formula, you can't do any kind of changes. That is called absolute referencing. A cell reference is made absolute by putting a dollar sign before the row name and the column, row name, or you can say that column letter, as well as row number of the desired cell. By before putting the dollar sign before the column letter as well as row number of the desired cell, such as name of this cell is E4. If I am saying E4, that is relative referencing. If I am saying $E$4, that is absolute referencing. Now here I have applied the formula. Earlier is F4 multiply G4. Now I have put the dollar sign before both the column letter as well as row number. That is called absolute referencing. But there is no impact in the formula. Value remains same. You can see, I will show you a plus sign, drag the mouse with the help of value remain constant because we have made it absolute. If you want to apply the formula, you can't drag the formula. Now see here, because same formula get applied in all the cells, the value remain constant throughout the cell. Now if I'll remove dollar sign before the column letter as well as row name, if I'll drag the mouse with the help of control key, that is the combination of both relative and absolute reference, that is called mixed referencing. If we just drag the formula which we have written in the form of absolute, then value remains constant because of the absolute referencing. Mixed reference is a combination of relative and absolute reference. As I have applied the formula here, F4, that is a relative reference. $G$4, that is absolute reference. This is the combination of absolute and relative referencing. One part of the cell address we have taken, row, column and the row is made up of absolute. Other part is of relative, such as $G$4. In mixed referencing, the cell reference change in one direction, row or column, while the part made of absolute remain same in the formula copy to the cell. In short, you can see that mixed reference is the combination of absolute as well as relative. Now we are going to next option we are going to discuss, that is defining and using name. First we are using range in this, then we are using function, sorting and filtering. First we are using defining and using name. Defining and using name, we are going to discuss to give a name to the range of cell. I want to give the range of cell. I have selected the range of cell in worksheet. Now I want to give a name to this range of cell. Select the range of cell first. Then right click on the range of cell. A pop-up menu appears. Click on the define name option. You can see pop-up menu will appear in front of you. Second last option in the pop-up menu, that is define name. Click on the define name option. The new name dialog box appear. The new name dialog box appear in front of you. You can see here. Give the name to the range of the cell. Write a name. Here I have given a name for the range of cell, EKMS. Range of cell I have given a name is EKMS. Then click on OK button. When you click on the OK button, the particular, click on the drop down, filter drop down button next to the column on which you want to apply the condition. From the drop down list, select the number or text filter and click. Text filter is given over there. Filter by color also you can apply. If you don't want to show any value, just select or unselect the all. Drop down, I want to show the mobile, specific value of the mobile. Select the mobile. Okay, it will display mobile. Rest of the topic we will discuss in next class. Thank you class. Range will be named and this name will be displayed in the name box also. You can see I have given the range name to the range of cell is AKMS. That name will be displayed in the AKMS. Whenever I will select any other cell, that time it will display the name of that cell. When I will select the range of these cells, then it will display their name AKMS in the name box. Now using name range in formula, look at the worksheet given in the in this table. Select the cell from E3 to E7. I have selected the range of cell from E3 to E7. Then select the cell right click on the cells, define name again. I'll give the this cell name is product. Okay, the name will be displayed in the again in the name box. You can give a name to the range of cell using define name option of the right click of that particular range of cells. Now if you want to display using name range in formula bar, that name is displayed in the formula bar also. You can see here when I select the range of cell, that is the select the range of cell, it is visible in the formula bar as well as in your name box also. Now I want to give this range of cell name, right click, define name. I have given name here is amount, rate multiply quantity, rate multiply quantity to the range of cell. That is not a valid name, that's why I have used here hyphen. Okay, you can give, then you can see here in the name box the name of this cells are amount displayed in the cell. When you select the range of this cell, that will display the rate. When I select this range, then it will select product in the formula one. When I select this range of cells, it will display quantity in the formula bar. Now we are going to discuss few more functions as we have discussed product, sum, average in our previous class. Now today we are going to discuss max and the minimum. Max function is used to find the maximum value in the given range of cells. Select the range of cells. Then how to find the maximum value? First you have to write equal max, then select the range of cell equal max bracket, then select the range of cell, then bracket close, press enter. It will display the maximum value from the given range of cell. In the same way, if you want to find the maximum value quantity from the given range of cell, equal max, select the range of cell, close bracket and press enter. It will display the maximum value in the given quantity is 4. In the same way, you can find the minimum value also. Equal min formula to find the minimum value from the given range of cell. Select the range of cell with the help of mouse, close bracket and press enter key. It will display the minimum rate in the given range of cell. One more time, I will tell you how to find the minimum value from the given range of cell. Equal min bracket open, select the range of cell, bracket close, press enter. It will display the minimum quantity from the range of cell is 1. Maximum function is used to find the maximum value, and minimum function is used to find the minimum value. How many entries I have done in the range of cell? To count function we are using. Equal count, select the range of cell, bracket close, enter. Equal count range of cell, bracket close, enter. Total entries I have done here, 4 entries. It will count the total number of entries, how many I have done in the range of cell. One more time I will tell you. Equal count bracket open, select the range of cell till where you want to count the number of entries, how many entries you have done in the worksheet, press enter key. It will display the total number of entries you have done, 4 in the worksheet. Now, next formula is to find the square root of a number. Just for example, here I have written a number 100. To find the square root of that number, how we will find? Equal SQRT, then bracket, select the cell with the help of mouse, bracket close, press enter. The square root of that number is 10. In the same way, you can find the square root of any number. Here I have written 8. You want to find the square root of that number, then equal SQRT. Whenever you are applying formula, first you have to put the equal sign, then the name of the cell, that is C14, bracket close, press enter. It will display the square root of that number. Now, how to display the current date and time with the help of today function. Name of the function is today. Whenever we are applying any formula in Excel, first you have to put equal sign, or you have to write equal sign, and press enter key. Equal today, open bracket, close bracket, and press enter. It will display the current date in the Excel. Now, all the function will be displayed in the formula bar. Whatever the formula we have applied, just click on that cell. That formula is visible on in the formula bar. Here I have applied which formula. Now next we are going to discuss sorting data. I want to arrange the data either in ascending order or descending order. For that we are using sorting data option. To arrange the data in largest to smallest, yes, smallest to largest, that is called sorting. Select the cell, click on the sort option under the home tab given over there in the editing group. Name of the group is editing. In editing group, sort option given there. Sort, click on the sort option. In which form you want to arrange the value, smallest to largest or largest to smallest? I have selected smallest to largest. Continue, expand the selection, or continue with the current selection. I have opt option here. Continue with the current selection. All the value get arranged. If on the basis of that, their amount get changed. Formula get automatically changed. You can see here. I want to arrange this value in the largest to smallest. Select the range of cell. Click on the sort and sort option in the home tab. Come under the editing group. Given in the editing group, choose option largest to smallest. Continue with the current selection. You will get arranged from largest to smallest. In this way, you can arrange your data largest to smallest or smallest to. You can arrange your alphabetic order also. Select the range of cell, sort, A to Z or Z to A? I said A to Z. Continue with the current selection. You can see alphabetically all the values are arranged. A, C, M, T. Alphabetically arranged with the help of sort option. Now, next is filter the data. Filtering is the process to extract the record from the worksheet that fulfills certain condition. It temporarily hides the row that do not want to see. First, we will discuss filter. Just click on that tab. In the editing group of Home tab, choose option filter. Filter options get applied on that. You want to see just AC. Rest select all first. Just want to see AC, just select the option. It will display specific value in the column or row. If you want to display all, again sort and filter option. Click on the filter. All the data will get you displayed in front of you. Select any cell. I select product. Click on the filter option. Filter get applied on your in the drop down of the filter.